Sooner or later, all will pay the price for their arrogance.
The stuff of legend. I was once summoned by Nervilet to discuss some matters with him in his office. When I approached the Palais Mermonia, I saw him standing by the road, completely drenched in the rain. I held out an umbrella for him, and, well, he thanked me politely. His expression was a little distressed, I guess. I can only assume that I had disturbed him in the middle of something. Miss Farina displayed a severe lack of interest in my trial and excused herself early, probably because I pleaded guilty to all charges as soon as they were announced. Disappointing the Hydro Archon is a big deal, so I suppose I got no choice but to keep gifting her copious amounts of the highest quality tea. Sijuin, the head nurse, possesses all the virtues associated with the medical profession and genuinely cares for the well-being of everyone around her. She seems to have picked up some bad habits from me, though, like frequently betting with her Melusine friends over who'd be able to put more stickers on my belongings. Not actually bothered by it. Chlorand is the best champion duelist you can find. Her combat prowess is already the stuff of legend. I've never fought her myself, but that's because there's never been a need for it. I'll admit that when I removed the House of the Heart's spies in the underworld, that was kind of an intentional provocation to the Fatui. But their only response was to send down a bunch of children. Was it because they truly saw those kids as disposable, or because they knew I wouldn't have it in me to let them come to serious harm? The Fortress of Meripede works with Spina di Rasula on some matters regarding supplies and logistics, but we don't have any other dealings. This isn't because I don't trust Navia or her abilities. In fact, I hold her in quite high regard. The only reason we continue to stay out of each other's way is because I want to honor the agreement I made with the late Mr. Callus. The Fortress of Meripede doesn't need her services. You know, some things are best preserved the way they are, warts and all, so people don't make the same mistakes twice. I say warts, but yeah, I mean smell. Most inmates seem to gain a new level of respect for the rules after receiving attention from the Special Security and Surveillance Patrol. As the captain, Chevreuse is an instrumental part of that team. Hello, please try to quickly summarize your intents and goals for this meeting. Oh, you're not here for business? Well, it just makes me even more nervous. All right, then perhaps we should sit down and discuss things in a little more detail. Oh, and you can call me Your Grace. That's what they all call me down in the fortress, and, well, I kind of got used to it. If you ever see any stickers on my back, do me a favor and take them off. Melusines like to play pranks sometimes. I once considered keeping some pets in my office, but soon gave up on the idea. It's just not right to keep small animals where they won't be able to see the sun. A word of advice, don't break the law. Is there anything else? Seriously, don't break the law. Ah, it's raining? That's all right. A real problem would be if we could feel water dripping on our heads in the Fortress of Meripede. You know, they say if you're scared of the thunder, it's really because you got something else to hide. This is a different kind of cold than what I'm used to. They say there's nothing new under the sun, but somehow a picnic in the warm sunshine never gets old. Morning. What do the papers have to say about today's weather forecast? The coupon cafeteria is probably crowded right now. I'll have someone deliver the food straight to my office. Is it evening already? I could have sworn I had just had my afternoon tea. Good night. I'll be staying up for a little while yet. Want to run some numbers while everything's nice and quiet. People have this tendency to see me as an all-knowing figure with mystical powers. In reality, I'm just one man with two eyes and two ears. How can I possibly know everything that's happening in the Fortress of Meripede? I finished serving my sentence long ago, so there's nothing stopping me from taking an occasional breather in the overworld as a free citizen. There's no need to worry. The Fortress of Meripede doesn't currently have any problems so big as to require my round-the-clock presence to operate effectively. I form my first impressions of many people based on the contents of their inmate registration papers. Seems like you're no exception to the rule. They say it's best to begin a friendship when there's no conflict of interest. Seems like the appropriate time has come. Some inmates once taught me a way to wield the elements by throwing around chemical potions. I guess whoever's in charge of handing out visions doesn't care too much about a little rule bending. You want a tip on how to escape from the guards? Just give yourself a name that's really long and difficult to pronounce. They'll be stumbling over your name as soon as they try to announce that you're under arrest. if a man will not work, he shall not eat. That phrase has been on the walls of the Fortress of Meripede for as long as anyone can remember. I don't know who first came up with it, but it's been pretty useful in the underworld. As a general rule, the less a person sees of me, the happier their life is. Oh, that scar on my body? It's from a gash I got while battling a gigantic undersea monster that tried to take over the Fortress of Meripede. I'm just kidding. Did you know many similar models of handcuffs can all be unlocked using the same master key? Except mine, of course. They're different. Honestly, my personal abilities are pretty limited. I got no talent in medicine, inventions, or shipmaking. But what I do know how to do is find those people with those talents and get them to come work for me. I've managed to get myself to a pretty comfortable place in life, but there's still some things I want that are outside my reach, like a peaceful and happy childhood or the ability to trust other people. Maybe some people would see those feelings as shameful or contradictory, but I don't see a problem with sharing them. After all, why should anybody be afraid to admit what they want? Boxing? To me, that's more of a necessity than a hobby. You got any suggestions for actual hobbies? While I do possess some stereotypical Fontanian looks, when you're an orphan, you can never really be sure where you're from. Who knows? Maybe I'll take a dip in the primordial sea one of these days just to check. I usually take some milk with my coffee and 2 cubes of sugar with my tea. You ever had one of Sijuin's milkshakes? The taste that comes to mind is... what's that flavor? Desolation. Whew, what a perfect blend of flavors. I could never have made this myself. Lovely. I'll be sure to treat you to something next time. Please excuse me. I'm gonna brew a cup of tea. Our tradition says that all children of Fontaine are born amid their parents' wishes and blessings. But I'd like to think that all children are born from such wonderful feelings. Anything that I can say to celebrate your birth would feel a little trivial next to that, right? Unfortunately, I won't be able to reduce your prison sentence if you were to commit a crime. The only thing I'd be able to pull off would be a special welfare meal for your birthday dinner. With all that in mind, why don't you try to respect the law a bit more around your birthday so we'll be able to celebrate somewhere nice on the surface? It is my honor to win your trust. Uh-oh. Looks like I'll owe you a favor now. Why do you look even more pleased about this than me? I like signs of strength and hope. They give me reassurance that tomorrow will be better than today. This isn't to be pessimistic, but it's impossible for the present to be without its doubts and troubles. That's just the truth. But come hell or high water, if nothing else, then at least we'll be able to figure it out together, right? Let's begin. Don't run away now. A moment, please. Have a safe trip. This could get a little chilly. Stay cool and face your guilt.
This wasn't locked. How convenient. I'd take it if I were you. I'm sure it'll come in handy. All unclaimed articles should be turned in. So, neither of us saw anything here, right?
No need to fear. No backup, huh? Fine by me. Time to improvise. Step back. Get to the infirmary. Sorry! I couldn't protect. Instead of going big, guess I'm going home. I have no objections. Going easy on me? Not bad.
Let's get to work. You got a side job for me? Sure thing. Yeah, I'll do my best, but I can't guarantee a victory.
会議のために、ヌビレットさんから呼ばれたことがあったが、外へ出て、パレメルモニアの正門に着いた頃、彼が道端で雨の中に突っ立っているのを見たんだ。傘を差し掛けてあげたんだが、礼は言われたものの、不自然な表情だった。おそらく、何かの邪魔をしてしまったのかもな。俺が罪を認めるのが早すぎたせいか。 フリーナ様は当時の審判でつまらなそうな顔をしながら早々に退場してしまった。水神様を失望させてしまうなんて、とんだ重大事故さ。今後はもっといい茶番を送って差し上げないとな。シグウィン看護師長は医療従事者として持つべき全ての美徳を兼ね備えた人物で、周りの仲間全員に気を配って、 だがどうやら俺から一部の悪癖を学んでしまったらしい。 例えば彼女はよくメルジーヌの友人と賭けをするんだ。俺の所有物により多くのステッカーを貼れた方が勝ちってな。まあ別に困っているわけではないが、クロリンデさんはあんたの見つけられる範囲じゃ一番いい決闘代理人だと思う。彼女の実力は申し分ないからな。まあ彼女と勝負したことはないが、その必要がなかったからな。認めよう。ハウス・オブ・ハースが水の下に仕込んだスパイを処理したのはある種の挑発だ。それなのにあっちの取った措置といえば子供を数人送り込んできただけだった。まったく困ったもんさ。本気で彼らを犠牲にしてもいいと思ってるのか、それとも俺が子供にひどいことはしないのを読んだのか。はあ、メロピデ要塞とスピナディロースらは物資について一部協力関係を築いてはいるが、それ以上のことはない。ナビアさんを信用してないとか彼女の能力を疑ってるってわけじゃないぞ。実を言えばその真逆さ。ただ水の上と下のジムにお互い干渉しないというのが俺とカーレスさんの間の約束だったから、それをそのままにしてるだけだ。メロピデ要塞に彼女のサービスは必要ないはずだ。一部の痕跡は前者の覆るは後者の戒めとして残されてる。匂いだって痕跡の一種だ。違うかい？特巡隊に世話になった囚人は基本おとなしい。あの隊長さんのおかげだな。どうも。要件を簡潔に説明してくれるかい？ん？仕事の件じゃない。そっちの方が逆に緊張するんだがな。とにかくまあ座ってくれ。ついでに俺のことは公爵と呼ぶといい。あいつらがみんなこう呼ぶもんだからもう慣れちまった。俺の背中にメルジーヌが書いたステッカーが貼ってあったら剥がしてくれるかい？執務室でペットを飼おうかと考えたことがあったが、日差しすら届かない場所で暮らすなんて犬や猫がかわいそうすぎると思ってやめたんだ。違法行為はしないよ。他に何か言っておくことはあったかな。ああ、違法行為はやめておいてくれ。雨か。それならよかった。メロピデ要塞で頭の上から水が降ってきたらそれこそ大問題だがな。心の中にやましいことがない限りはこんな天気でも安眠できるはずさ。ふん。水の下の寒さとはやっぱり違うな。太陽の下、新しきものは何一つなしというが、いい場所を見つけてピクニックができそうだぞ。おはよう。長官の天気予報にはどう書いてあった？この時間帯の特別許可食堂は混んでるからな。執務室まで運んでもらおう。もうこんな時間か。アフタヌーンティーを飲み終えたばっかりかと思ってたんだ。おやすみ。俺ももう少ししたら寝るさ。この夜の静けさを借りていろいろ清算しようと思ってな。俺のことを深すぎる謎に包まれた人物とか全能すぎる人物だと思ってくれているやつが多いみたいだが、あいにく俺は二つの目と二つの耳しか持ち合わせてないんだ。メロピデ要塞の隅々にまで目や耳が届くわけないだろ。俺のケーキはとっくに終わってるから、今は自由な市民さ。もちろん水の上をぶらつくことだってできる。案ずることはない。俺がずっと居座ってないとメロピデ要塞が安定して運転できないなんてかえって不健全だろ。俺が誰かに抱く第一印象は大抵中間登録リストから来てる。どうやらあんたも例外じゃないらしい。利益のやり取りがなくなって初めて友達になれるって言うだろ。今から始めてもいいぞ。昔 囚人から化学薬品を使って元素を使う方法を学んだことがある。神の目の配布をどの部門が管理してるのかは知らないが、これくらいの分不相応は気にしないらしいな。警察隊の捜査から逃げる方法を知ってるかい？それはな、自分に長ったらしく覚えにくい名前をつけることだ。そしたら奴らが誰々手を挙げろと叫びたいとき済むからな。働かざる者食うべからずという言葉はかなり昔からメロピデ要塞の壁に刻み込まれてる。誰の仕業かは知らんが、水の下じゃ確かに使えるな。理論上俺のことを全く知らない者の方がより幸せな生活を送れる。俺の体にある傷跡、かつて深海の巨獣がメロピデ要塞を占拠しようと攻め込んできた時にそいつとの喧嘩でできた傷跡というのはもちろん嘘だ。信じるなよ。知ってるか、手錠っていうのは型番が近ければ大抵は共通の鍵で開けられるんだ。俺が持ってるやつだけは例外だけどな。俺一人の能力には限りがある。俺は病気の治療もできないし、発明品を作ることもできないだろ。それに巨大な船を作ることだってもちろん不可能だ。だがこういうことをやれる者がどこにいるかを俺は分かっているから、みんなはただ俺の顔を立ててくれるのさ。今の俺はそれなりにいい暮らしをしてるが、それでも手に入らない一部のものが羨ましい。平和で楽しい子供時代と簡単に他人を信じることのできる力だ。矛盾してるとか言いづらいとかそう思う者もいるらしいが、俺は別にこの気持ちを認めてもいいと思ってる。己の本心に逆らって何になる。見当、趣味とまでは言えないな。ただ生活する上で必須なもんさ。他に何かおすすめの趣味はあるかい？俺は確かにフォンテーヌ人らしい顔つきをしてるが、100% 確定ってわけでもないな。大会に飛び込んで確認してみるしかないか。コーヒーを飲むなら俺はミルクを入れる方だ。お茶なら砂糖二つでいい。看護師長の作ったミルクセーキを飲んだことはあるかい？そうだな。不毛の味を味わえるぞ。完璧なさじ加減だ。俺にはやれそうもないな。うまいな。次は俺がごちそうしよう。お茶を入れてくる。待っていてくれ。フォンテーヌの子供なら両親の願いと祝福と共にこの世に生まれてくるもんだ。だがこの世にいる全員がそうなのだと俺は信じたい。それと比べれば俺からの祝福なんていうのはつまらないものになってしまうな。いや、もしあんたが罪を犯してしまってもケーキを減らすことはできないぞ。特殊なサービス職を用意するくらいしかできそうにない。だから誕生日の間はおとなしくしててくれ。せっかくのお祝いなんだからきちんと水の上でやろうな。あんたに信用してもらえて光栄だ。これであんたに恩を返さないといけなくなったな。なぜ俺よりも得意げな顔してる？力と希望の兆しは好きだ。この先の未来は全てが良くなっていく。そう感じさせてくれるからな。別に悲観的に考えてるわけじゃないぞ。ただ事実を述べてるだけさ。何せ現実世界では常に物事が順風満帆に行くわけじゃないからな。だがいいニュースもある。悪いことが起こってしまう時には俺らは同じ側に立っているはずさ。そうだな、始めよう。逃げるなって。少しいいかい？行ってらっしゃい。寒いから気をつけろよ。恐れなくていいさ。罪に向き合うんだ。鍵がついてなかったのか。都合が良かったな。とりあえず閉まっておこう。 いつか役に立つ主なき者、公に帰すべし。でも最初からここには何もなかっただろ。焦るな、増援は望めないって。まあいいさ、タイミングを見計らうんだぞ。下がれ、医務室へ行け。すまない、守りきれなかった。大博打の結果がこのざまか。意義なしだ。ずいぶん遠慮がちだな。ほうほう、やるか。外の仕事か。行こう、最善を尽くすが勝利の保証はしないぞ。